is Nairobi News Bulletin. My name is Christine Mayama. Congolese musician Koffi Olomide was on Friday captured on camera assaulting one of his female dancers moments after he landed at the Jomo Kenyatta International Airport. Police officers were forced to intervene and hold back the entertainer, who appeared unperturbed by what he had done. The female dancer had reportedly slapped Koffi's lead singer Cindy, triggering the altercation. Rescue work at the site of a collapsed foundation wall in Westlands came to a close early Friday morning, with the National Disaster Management Unit reporting that four bodies of missing workers had been retrieved. 14 construction workers were buried under the rubble when part of a wall that they were building caved in Thursday afternoon. 10 people were rescued.
At exactly 19:30 hours Thursday night, KDF disaster management team, together with NYS officers, dig deep into the earth carefully to free a body discovered in the rubble deep into this foundation at a construction site. It would take them another 8 hours to recover two more bodies trapped here, bringing the total of the dead to four. Workers here say that their colleagues were caught off guard and had little time to escape when part of this wall came tumbling over them like an avalanche. 10 were rescued alive and received treatment before being discharged.
I just observed there is a construction going on simultaneously with the excavation, which I think is not acceptable in law, because there are vibrations here and there, and that could have caused the wall to fall down.
Gigiri police boss Vitali Sotieno says rescue efforts were slow in the first 2 hours after the wall collapsed, making it hard for those covered in a lot of rubble to be rescued alive. For 12 hours, rescuers raced against the clock to retrieve the bodies.
I would like to point a finger at our enforcement, where I chair as an oversight body, that we did not play our part the way it's supposed to, and we'll have to take a blame.
We are doing a thorough investigation. We have a team from the CID who are investigating the incident.
Among those rescued alive, 9 have been discharged while 1 remains in hospital. The collapse of this wall adds to the number of buildings collapsing in the city. The reasons for these tragedies are yet to be revealed, despite investigations into almost all of them, and virtually no one has been held accountable.
22 high school students from Iego Secondary School in Murang'a spent the night at Kangema Police Station after they were arrested for attempted arson. Kangema Police Station OCPD Cosmas Washengoka says they received a distress call from Rahab Murevi, the school principal, alerting the authorities of the students' plans to burn the school down. The boys will appear before a Kangema court to face charges for attempted arson.
Tumekuwa tukisumbuana na walimu sana. Juu ya kwanza, they have an equal treatment. Kulingana na sitting posture ya darasa, unapata kutoka hapo mbele, ameweka watu wenye wao perform, watu wenye au watu wenye anapendelea, na kurudi sasa nyuma unapata ni watu wenye yani wanahitaji kusaidiwa sana. They are discouraging someone, yani unapata mtu kabla akwambie ama akuonyeshe venye utapita, yeye tu kazi yake ni ku discourage.
Tukaza kufanya sorting pale, ndio tukupopata hao vijana wengine ambao walikuwa hawana vitu, waka volunteer tu kusema kwa Tulikuwa na fulani. Tukafanya sorting kabisa, tulipomaliza tukapata vijana 22.
And in a bizarre incident, a woman was arrested a few hours after giving birth on Wednesday, leaving her infant in hospital after her employer falsely accused her of stealing 90,000 shillings from her M-Pesa shop. The woman's husband is demanding a DNA on the baby, alleging the arrest was a plot by the police and the hospital to swap the infant with another. The new mother had taken the supposedly missing money to another office, as is the norm before heading home and going into labor. That's it from us now. For this and more stories, log on to www.nairobinews.co.ke. I am Christine Maima. Goodbye.